Online viewers, I take this opportunity to welcome you, even as we hear your the word of God this morning. If you come by Nairobi, just come to Muranga Road and worship with us. Meanwhile, wherever you are, you'll also hear the word of God. Church, let's appreciate the worship there that the online viewers. It's also good to see you this morning. You are wonderful people. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The message that the Lord has given this morning, and He has deposited in my heart that I may share with us, is the power of spiritual keys. Amen.
Amen.
The power of spiritual keys. Reading comes from Matthew chapter 16 and verse 19. Matthew 16 and verse 19. The Bible says,
Biblia yasema,
I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven.
Nami nitakupa wewe funguo za ufalme wa mbinguni.
Mark the word key. Keys.
Piga mstari pale funguo.
Whatever you bind here on earth,
lolote mtakalofunga duniani,
will be bound in heaven.
Litakuwa limefungwa mbinguni.
And whatever you lose on earth,
na lolote mtakalolifungua duniani,
will be loosed in heaven.
Litafunguliwa mbinguni.
Heavenly Father, we are grateful.
Baba tunashukuru.
For your word this morning.
Neno lako asubuhi ya leo.
As I share about the spiritual keys of Jehovah.
Baba shikusu funguo za kiroho Jehovah.
Lord, help us to use those keys.
Saidia tutumize ufunguo Baba.
To the glory of your holy name.
Kwa utukufu wa jina lako.
Receive the glory, honor and praises.
Pokea sifa na utukufu na sifa.
In Jesus name we pray.
Katika jina la Yesu naomba.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
You may sit down.
Mnaweza kuketi.
Do we have someone with a bunch of keys?
Je, kuna mtu ako na vifunguo?
You have a number of keys. There are many.
Na vifunguo mingi.
You can raise up your hand.
Inua mkono wako.
Someone with a bunch of keys.
Ambaye ana vifunguo mingi.
There are quite a number of keys.
Iko na vifunguo mingi.
Hallelujah. You don't have. Yeah. Good. We have also, okay. Karithi, come here.
Karithi, njoo hapa.
We also have our sister, you can come.
Unaweza kuja pia dada yetu, unaweza kuja na
zako. Just come. There are a bunch of keys here.
Ni kifunguo mingi hapa.
And, yes. Don't go.
Usiende.
What is this one for?
Ini ya nini?
Eh? The other one?
Yo ingine.
No, the small one.
Yo dog.
You see. No. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, the other one?
Yo ingine.
And the other one? Good. And your keys?
Nazako Karevi.
Uh-huh. The main gate. Yeah, he stays in a gate. A gate at the community. Amen. This one. Okay, that one. And the other one? For the office. This one? No idea. And this one? No idea. That is what I wanted. They have keys. Some of the keys are dormant.
Fungo vingine azitumiki.
They have them,
wakonazo,
but they have no idea
lakini hawana wazo,
why they have those keys.
Mbona kuna zile vifunguo?
Are we together?
Tuko pamoja.
In life,
maishani,
there are keys.
Kuna vifunguo.
Or we have keys.
Ama tumepewa vifunguo.
But some of the keys,
lakini vifunguo vingine,
are just dormant.
Azitumiki, hazina kazi.
Some of the keys we don't use them.
Vifunguo vingine hatutumii.
And therefore this morning,
na kwa hivyo asubuhi ya leo,
We have, okay. He has two keys. He has no idea
ambazo ana wazo
why he's carrying them.
Bona amezibeba.
She has one key.
Akuna funguo moja.
She has no idea.
Ambaye ajui.
Why is that key is there?
Bona ule funguo uko pale.
Yet she is the one who put that key there. Christians have keys. Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
And some of the keys, we are not using them. From today, it is a time to discover the types of key that we have. And we should not have dormant keys. Let's appreciate them. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
As we know, a door is a barrier. But once you have a key, it becomes a walkway. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
On Wednesday,
Jumatano,
I was here.
Nilikuwa hapa.
And because the person who is here was in my office, where I go to pray, I came to pray in the church and took a bit of time. But when I was here, there's someone who came and knocked, rang the bell. That person could not enter because there was a barrier. Until the person in charge went and opened the door. And whoever came rang the bell. In other words, he requested. So there are keys that we have that we can use. But others we have to request. Because there are some doors that are locked. And we may not have keys. But we have the one who has the keys. Jesus Christ.
Yesu Christo.
And whoever was knocking, the door was open. And even there, I didn't even realize who came. Because I was busy praying. But later on, I came to realize who that person was. Hallelujah. In life, we face and experience obstacles of closed doors. And these doors limit our spiritual and physical lives. Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
And as we know, a closed door will leave someone or a believer, you know, make someone live in pain. Or even a struggle of life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But the keys
lakini funguo
give us power and authority.
Utupa nguvu na mamlaka.
Listen good.
Sikiza vizuri.
And this one is very, very important.
Na hii ni ya muhimu sana.
This statement is very, very important.
Hii ni ya muhimu sana.
Keys
funguo
give us power
utupatia nguvu
and authority
na mamlaka
to access.
Kuweza kufikia.
Give us power and authority to access
upatia nguvu na mamlaka kuweza kufikia
and control certain domains of life.
Na kuweza kuwa mwenye shughuli kwa mambo ya maisha.
There are domains of life.
Kuna vitu vya maisha.
There are places we are supposed to be.
Kuna mahali tunapaswa kuwa.
And we must be there.
Lazima tuwe pale.
And when we are there,
na tukiwa pale,
we can either close or open that door.
Tunaweza funga ama tufungue mlango.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
The same key.
Ule ufunguo.
We can use it to close a door.
Tunaweza tumia kufunga mlango.
To avoid intruders coming in.
Kuweza kuzuia watu ambao hawafai kuingia.
And therefore, by the grace of God,
kwa hivyo kwa neema ya Mungu,
today there are doors that will be opened in your life in the name of Jesus. There are doors that you're going to close because you don't deserve them. They have brought pain in your life and they might be closed in the name of Jesus. Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
We have different keys. As we have, as we demonstrated here, we have keys we use to open doors, probably opening our gates, opening our bedrooms or sitting room, a car you can use to open your vehicle. You can open you can open the door of your vehicle. Did you know?
Je, unajua?
You can have a new vehicle.
Unaweza kuwa na gari mpya.
With fuel.
Ikiwa na mafuta.
And everything.
Na vyote.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
But if you don't have keys.
Lakini kama hauna funguo.
You'll never drive or use that car.
Hautaweza kuendesha ama kutumia ile gari.
And that is what is happening in life.
Linafanyika maisha.
There are things that we have,
kuna vitu tuko navyo,
at our disposal,
ambavyo tumepewa,
but we cannot have them,
lakini hatuwezi kuwa nazo,
because we don't have keys,
sababu hatuna funguo,
or probably we ignore the keys that we have,
ama labda tunadharau ile funguo tuko
nayo. And in the name of Jesus,
na katika jina la Yesu,
I pray that each and every one of you,
naomba kila mmoja wenu,
will get a good house,
atapata nyumba nzuri,
will get a good car,
atapata gari nzuri.
And above that,
na juu ya hiyo,
you will have keys,
utakuwa na funguo,
to access,
kuweza kufikia.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
Let's appreciate the Lord of Lords.
Tushangilie Bwana wa mabwana.
This is a phone.
Hii ni simu.
In Kenya,
apa Kenya,
because listeners are coming from different countries, in Kenya,
apa Kenya,
there is what we call M-Pesa. And also M-Shwari.
Na pia M-Shwari.
For you to access M-Pesa,
ili uweze kufikia M-Pesa,
you must use a key.
Lazima utumie funguo.
And that is a pin.
Na hiyo ni pin yako.
A pin is a key.
Namba yako ya siri ni funguo.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
You may have money,
unaweza kuwa na pesa,
in your M-Pesa,
katika M-Pesa yako,
or in your M-Shwari,
ama kwa M-Shwari yako,
but if you don't remember your pin number,
lakini kama ukumbuki namba yako ya
you
siri,
cannot access that money.
Hauwezi fikia zile pesa.
Are we together?
Tuko pamoja.
You may have an account,
unaweza kuwa na account,
but if you are not able, if you cannot remember your account pin number,
lakini kama ukumbuki namba ya siri ya hiyo account,
you cannot access your money.
Hauwezi fikia pesa zako.
There are things that God has given us.
Kuna vitu Mungu ametupatia.
They are for us.
Ni zetu.
They belong to us.
Ni zetu.
But sometimes we suffer.
Okay, ni tunateseka.
Yet those things we have them.
Ila hizo vitu tuko navyo.
It's at our disposal.
Viko ambavyo tumepewa.
God has given us the key.
Mungu ametupatia funguo.
But the key we have forgotten.
Lakini funguo tumesahau.
From today, in the name of Jesus,
kuanzia leo katika jina la
Yesu, I pray that the grace,
naomba neema,
of divine keys,
ya funguo za kiungu,
will be released,
itaachiliwa,
so that you can access what you need to access in Jesus' name.
Ili ufikie kile unapaswa kufikia katika jina la Yesu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
And you know, in the spiritual, we struggle if we don't have, also in the spiritual,
kwa kiroho pia,
that was physical.
Ilikuwa kiasili.
In the spiritual,
katika kiroho,
people will struggle,
watu utangangana,
if they forget,
wakieza kusahau,
or fail to use their keys.
Ama kukosa kutumia funguo zao.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus said in Matthew 28 and verse 18,
Yesu akasema katika Mathayo 28 mstari wa 18.
All authority,
mamlaka yote,
in heaven and on earth,
binguni na duniani,
has been given to me.
Nimepewa mimi.
Jesus was talking to his disciples.
Yesu alikuwa zungumza na wanafunzi
wake. And he was telling his disciples,
alikuwa anambia wanafunzi wake,
not just a few,
sio chache,
but all the authority,
lakini mamlaka yote,
praise the name of the living God,
amen,
in heaven and on earth,
binguni na duniani,
has been given to me.
Nimepewa mimi.
Jesus had authority to heal the sick.
Yesu alikuwa na mamlaka ya kuponya wagonjwa.
Jesus has authority to heal the sick even today.
Yesu alikuwa na mamlaka ya kuponya wagonjwa hata leo.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
Jesus had power and authority to command wind and waves to stop.
Yesu alikuwa na mamlaka na nguvu ya kuamuru mawimbi yasiache.
Amen.
Amen.
He was with his disciples.
Alikuwa na wanafunzi wake.
When they were experienced wind and also, you know, they experienced wind and waves.
Ambao walipatana mawimbi na pia upepo.
He just stopped it.
Alisimamisha.
Jesus has power to ensure that those blind eyes are open.
Yesu kuna nguvu ya kufanya vipofu waone.
He has power even to raise the dead.
Akona nguvu ya kufufua wafu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He has also power and authority to make the impossible happen.
Akona nguvu na mamlaka ya kufanya sio wezekana ya wezekana.
But having all this power,
like, kuwa na hizi nguvu zote,
he realized
aligundua
that he had walked with his disciples for many years.
Alikuwa na wanafunzi kwa muda mrefu.
And not only his disciples,
na sio wanafunzi tu,
but also us, the church of Jesus Christ.
Lakini pia sisi kama kanisa ya Yesu Kristo.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And therefore, Jesus gave us the keys. He gave us power and authority to do the impossible. He says in Matthew 16:19, I'll give you the keys of the kingdom. And here the keys are in plural. That is to say there are many. Whatever you bind here on earth,
chochote mtafunga duniani,
whatever door that you close here on earth,
mlango wote mtafunga hapa duniani,
it will be closed.
Itafungwa.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There are doors that you must close today.
Kuna milango lazima ufunge leo.
The doors of frustrations must be closed.
Milango ya ghadhabika lazima ifungwe.
The doors of sicknesses must be closed.
Milango ya magonjwa lazima ifungwe.
The doors of suffering must be closed.
Milango ya mateso lazima ifungwe.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
He says,
anasema,
whatever that you bind here on earth,
chochote mtafunga hapa duniani,
in heaven the heavens will respond.
Bingu pia itajibu.
The Father will say amen.
Baba atasema amina.
And whatever you open or loosen here on earth,
chochote mtafungua,
or in heaven,
chochote mtafungua hapa duniani,
whatever you lose here on earth,
ambacho mtafungua hapa duniani,
will also be loosed in heaven.
Kitafunguliwa pia.
In other words,
kwa mwingine,
we have a key.
Tunafunguo.
When we use that key,
tukitumia ile funguo,
heaven says amen.
Bingu nasema amina.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
In Luke chapter 10 and verse 19.
Luka 10 mstari wa 19.
Jesus Christ said,
Yesu Kristo akasema,
I have given you authority.
Nimewapatia nguvu.
To trample on snakes and scorpions.
Kukanyanga nyoka na nge.
In other words, satanic powers.
Kwa mengine nguvu za kishetani.
And to overcome
na kuweza kushinda
all the power of the enemy,
nguvu zote za adui,
and nothing will harm you.
Na kile chochote kitawadhuru.
Amen.
Amen.
With the revelation,
kwa ufunuo,
that we have been given power and authority,
kuwa tumepewa nguvu na mamlaka,
and keys of the kingdom,
na funguo za ufalme,
I want to share with us,
nataka kushiriki nasi,
about few keys. There are several of them, but today I'll just share four of them. If God allows, I'll share the rest in future. Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know we have different doors. Can I have five volunteers? Five people volunteers quickly. Quickly, five. Where are you? From different sides.
Toka mahali tofauti watano.
Yes, five people, quickly.
Aone wanne mmoja amebaki.
Amen. Sisters, are you? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Just make a circle. Can I have another? Yeah, make a circle. Make a big circle. Alafu mshikane. Sawa. Just come here. Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
Here
Apa
is a believer. And this verse did not click in my mind.
Na hii andiko alikuja kwa mawazo yangu.
That it is a key.
kuwa ni funguo.
And I was sharing with my friend.
Nilikuwa nashiki na marafiki zangu.
One friend.
Rafiki mmoja.
And I told him.
Nikamwambia,
I have a need.
Niko na hitaji.
He's a very close friend.
Ni rafiki wa karibu sana.
And this is the situation.
Na hii ndio hali.
So pray with me.
Tafadhali omba nami.
That God may meet this need.
Kwa Mungu akutane na hili hitaji.
For the Bible says.
Biblia inasema.
Where two or three gathers.
Mahali wawili wamekusanyika
watatu. And they pray.
Na waombe.
God will answer.
Mungu atajibu.
So we prayed.
Kwa hivyo tukaomba.
I was preaching in his church.
Nilikuwa nahubiri kwa kanisa yake.
Amen.
Amen.
After I preached.
Baada ya kuhubiri.
He told the church.
Akaambia kanisa.
Church.
Kanisa.
We have our bishop here.
Tuko na askofu wetu hapa.
And he has a need.
Na ako na hitaji.
And it is good to meet that need.
Ni mzuri kukutana na hilo hitaji.
And it was a need of a big money, good money.
Ilikuhitaji pesa mingi.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
My car had broken down.
Gari ya askofu ilikuwa
imevunjika. I didn't know what to do.
Sikujua nifanye nini.
It needed a lot of money.
Ilikuhitaji pesa mingi.
I even didn't tell you.
Hata sikuambia.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
Over 300,000.
Karibu 300,000.
When I shared.
Nilipo eleza huyo.
After preaching,
baada ya kuhubiri,
pastor came and said,
mchungaji akaja akasema,
there is one person,
kuna mtu mmoja,
who has said,
ambaye amesema,
he will take care of your problem,
atashughulikia shida zako.
I was also going to another church.
Nilikuwa na kanisa nyingine pia.
I didn't know that also he had shared with that pastor.
Sikujua pia ameshika yule mchungaji.
After preaching.
Baada ya kuhubiri.
The pastor says.
Mchungaji akasema.
I know bishop don't know.
Najua askofu hajui.
Because he has not shared with me.
Sababu hajaniambia.
But I know he has a need.
Lakini najua anahitaji.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
And therefore church.
Kwa hivyo kanisa.
And let us meet his need.
Tunahitaji hilo lake.
And out of that.
Baada ya
I was also blessed.
Nikabarikiwa pia.
After that I went to my friend.
Baada hiyo nikaenda kwa rafiki yangu.
Who is an apostle now.
Ambao ni mtume sasa.
I asked him.
Nikamuuliza.
Why did you share?
Bona ulisema.
Because I was sharing with you.
Sababu nilikuwa nakueleza wewe.
So that you can pray with me.
Ili uombe na mimi.
And then he told me.
Akanambia.
You know bishop.
Unajua askofu.
You can pray forever.
Unaweza omba milele.
And you might not get an answer.
Na labda hutapata jibu.
Because the Bible says.
Maana Biblia inasema.
You do not have.
Hauna.
Because you do not ask.
Sababu haulizi.
So when you asked me,
wakati ulinieleza,
I asked on your behalf.
Nikauliza kwa niaba yako.
And that is why the need was met.
Ndio maana hitaji likakutana nalo.
Are we together?
Kwa pamoja.
From that day,
kutoka hiyo siku,
I realized.
Niligundua.
I also need to share my needs.
Nahitaji pia kushiriki kama kueleza.
Let's appreciate the Lord of Lords.
Tushangilie Bwana wa mabwana.
Recently,
hivi karibuni,
we shared with us here.
Tulishiriki nasi hapa.
That we needed a microwave.
Tulihitaji microwave.
In the church.
Kanisani.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
So when I came this morning.
Nilipokuja asubuhi ya leo.
Went to the office, to my office.
Kingia kwa ofisi yangu.
On my fridge.
Pale juu ya fridge.
I found a new microwave.
Nikapata microwave mpya pale.
Even this hour, I don't know who bought it.
Hata sijui nani alinunua.
But I have prayed for him or her.
Lakini nimemuombea.
Or for those people who bought it.
Ama watu ambao walinunua.
Why?
Kwa nini?
The need was shared in this place.
Itaji ilisemwa hapa.
And therefore the Bible says in the book of James.
Vinasema katika waraka wa Yakobo.
You do not have because you do not ask.
Amuna sababu hamuombi wala kuuliza.
Hallelujah, the pastor. You do not have because you do not ask.
Amuna kwa sababu amuulizi.
Prayer is a key that opens doors.
Maombi ni funguo ambayo inafungua milango.
And therefore James is telling us.
Kwa hivyo Yakobo anatuambia.
That God opens the doors. There are some doors that God opens when we ask.
Kwa kuna milango Mungu fungua tunapomuuliza.
Look at this.
Angalia hii.
Colossians 4, chapter 4:3.
Kolosai 4:3.
Colossians chapter 4:3.
Kolosai 4 mstari wa 3.
This is Paul.
Paulo,
and he's talking to the church of Colossians. And he says,
anasema,
Colossians,
Wakolosai,
pray for us
mniombeni,
so that God may open a door
ili Mungu aweze kufungua mlango,
for a message.
Ya ujumbe.
So that we may proclaim the mysteries of Christ.
Ili tueneze siri za Kristo.
For which I am in chain.
Ambayo ni kwa mefungwa kwa ajili yake.
So Paul is telling Colossians church.
Paulo anambia kanisa wa Kolosai.
When you pray.
Mukiomba.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God may open a door.
Mungu anaweza fungua mlango.
When you pray,
ukiomba,
there is a key that will be used.
Kuna mlango ambao utatumika.
And this is the key of prayer.
Na hii ni funguo ya maombi.
And Colossians, when you pray for me,
Wakolosai mkiniombea,
God will open a door.
Mungu atafungua mlango.
To preach the gospel.
Kuweza kuhubiri injili.
It is my prayer in the name of Jesus.
Niombe mlango katika jina la Yesu.
Even the door of preaching the gospel the whole of this area and Kenya.
Hata mlango wa kuhubiri injili.
May God open those doors.
Afungue mlango.
By giving us resources and time.
Kutupa muda na pesa.
Health and everything that we need.
Afya na vitu tunahitaji.
So that we can reach out.
Ili tuweze kufikia.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know Jesus Christ.
Unajua Yesu Kristo.
The Son of the Living God.
Mwana wa Mungu aishie.
He prayed.
Aliomba.
And after prayer,
na baada ya maombi,
the Bible tells me,
Biblia niambia,
the heavens opened,
mbingu zilifunguka,
the Father spoke,
Baba akazungumza,
and the Holy Spirit descended,
Roho Mtakatifu akashuka,
and led him throughout,
na akamgongoza
kila, in the name of Jesus,
katika jina la Yesu,
it is my prayer,
ni ombi langu,
that God will open every door,
Mungu atafungua kila mlango,
that you need in your life,
ambao unahitaji maishani mwako.
Jabez prayed,
Jabez akaomba,
and said,
na akasema,
my God bless, bless me.
Mungu wangu nibariki.
Enlarge my territories.
Panua mipaka yangu.
Keep me from evil.
Niondoe kwa maovu.
Remove pain.
Ondoa machungu.
In my life.
Maishani mwangu.
And the Bible says.
Binasema.
That God answered.
Mungu akajibu.
And that is in the. Yeah, he prayed. That is in the First Chronicles chapter 4 and verse 10.
Hii katika mambo ya nyakati 4 mstari wa
my prayer this morning.
Ombi langu asubuhi ya leo.
It that may God
nikuwa Mungu
bless me.
Akubariki.
May God
Mungu wangu
enlarge your boundaries.
Apanue mipaka yako.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
May God remove every pain.
Mungu aondoe kila machungu
that you have been going through.
Ambao umekuwa ukipitia.
May the presence of God be with you.
Uwepo wa Mungu uwe nawe.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
May he keep you from evil.
Akuondoe kwa uovu.
To the glory of the Almighty God.
Kwa utukufu wa Mungu mkuu.
The Bible says.
Binasema.
In the book of Acts chapter 12.
Kitabu cha Matendo ya Mitume 12.
That Peter was kept in prison.
Kwa Petero waliwekwa katika jela.
And verse 5 says.
Mstari wa 5 unasema.
The church prayed.
Kanisa likaomba.
Church, we should not sleep.
Kanisa tufai kulala.
And when the church prayed,
kanisa ikipomba,
the locked doors,
mlango ambao ulikuwa umefungwa,
the chains were broken,
minyororo ikakatika,
the doors were open,
milango ikafunguka,
and Peter was set free.
Petero akawekwa huru.
In the name of Jesus,
katika jina la Yesu,
it is my prayer, oh God,
niombi langu ewe Mungu,
there are people who are chained here,
kuna watu wamefungwa hapa,
in different ways, Jehovah,
kwa njia tofauti, Jehovah,
may those chains be broken,
hiyo minyororo ivunjike,
in the name of Jesus,
katika jina la Yesu,
the chain of stagnation,
minyororo ya kukwama,
the chains of pain, the chains of struggle, may they be opened right now,
ivunjike sasa,
in the name of Jesus,
katika jina la Yesu,
the physical and the spiritual, the physical and spiritual chains,
minyororo ya kiroho na kiasili,
may they be broken in Jesus' name,
ivunjike katika jina la Yesu,
and may the doors that you have been waiting for,
na milango ambayo ukingoja,
be open and be set free in Jesus' name.
Ifungwe na wekwe huru katika jina la Yesu.
Let us appreciate the Lord of Lords.
Shangilie Bwana wa mabwana.
The King of Kings.
Mfalme wa falme.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Prayer is a priority.
Maombi ni sehemu ya kwanza.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But it has been thrown into the back seat.
Lakini imerushwa kiti cha nyuma.
I repeat again.
Narudia tena.
Prayer.
Maombi
is a priority.
Ni sehemu ya kwanza.
In the life of a believer.
Kwa maisha ya Mkristo.
In the church.
Kanisani.
But it's been thrown into the back seat.
Lakini imerushwa kiti ya nyuma.
It is no longer a priority.
Sio sehemu ya kwanza tena.
Because ask people to come for breakfast.
Ukiuliza watu waje katika chakula ya asubuhi.
Everybody will come.
Kila mtu atakuja.
Ask people.
Uliza watu.
To come for music extravaganza.
Waje kuchangamsha kwa nyimbo.
Are we together?
Tuko pamoja.
And also probably entertainment.
Na pia jambo ya kufurahisha.
People will flock there.
Watu wanafurika pale.
But ask people.
Lakini uliza watu.
To come for prayer.
Waje kwa maombi.
You'll only get very few.
Utapata wachache.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
It is my prayer.
Ni ombi langu.
That there will be a turnaround.
Kutakuwa na kugeuka.
We cannot have what is happening in Kenya.
Hatuwezi kuwa kile kinafanyika Kenya.
Today what is happening in Kenya.
Kile kinafanyika Kenya.
If we totally give ourselves unto God.
Tukijitoa kabisa kwa Mungu.
What is happening will stop. Because we pray for the president, he will have wisdom to deal with the issues. Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
Economy will thrive. Our young youth will get jobs. Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
And struggles will end in the name of Jesus. Our God is well able. Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
This narrative of prayerlessness
kutoomba
in our lives and in the lives of believers in the church must end in Jesus' name.
Lazima ikome katika jina la
Yesu. So we must arise.
Lazima tukuinuke.
Take the key of prayer.
Tuafungue maombi.
And be prayerful.
Na uwe mtu wa kuomba.
The question is.
Swali ni.
We have Bible studies. No, we pray on Wednesday.
Tunaomba Jumatano.
We pray on Friday.
Tunaomba Ijumaa.
We pray. We also go for keshas.
Tunaenda pia mkesha.
Like this week we'll have a kesha on Friday.
Kama nyuma tutakuwa na mkesha Ijumaa.
The question is.
Swali ni.
How many are available?
Ni wangapi wanapatikana?
The whole of this year.
Hii mwaka yote.
How many have you come? Just to kneel down on Friday and to say thank you Lord for the gift of life. Church
kanisa
is a challenge.
Ni changamoto.
This church is open 24/7. Even when, as long as you request, you want to come and pray. I know a chance will be
availed.
Wednesday, Friday, or any other time. Let us use the key of prayer in Jesus' name. Because the prayer of a righteous person is effective and powerful. In Jesus' name. Quickly, in Jesus' name. The other key is the key of divine healing. The key of divine healing. That John chapter 1 and verse 2.
Waraka wa Yohana 3.
Or 3 John verse 2, because there is only one chapter.
Waraka wa Yohana 2.
The Bible says,
binasema,
dear friends,
wapendwa,
I pray that you may enjoy.
Naomba mfurahikie.
What is to enjoy?
Kufurahikia nini?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Is to be happy.
Ni kuwa na furaha.
And the writer,
na mwandishi,
he says,
anasema,
I pray that you may enjoy good health.
Naomba ufurahie afya jema.
And that it may go well with you.
Na iende vema na wewe.
Even as your soul is getting along well.
Hata nafsi yenu inapoenda vizuri.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We reject the spirit of sickness.
Tunakataa roho ya magonjwa.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
It is not our portion.
Sio sehemu yetu.
It is not your portion.
Sio sehemu yako.
In Jesus' name.
Katika jina la Yesu.
There is a key there.
Kuna funguo pale.
John said,
Yohana anasema,
my prayer
ombi langu
is that you may enjoy good health.
Ufurahikie afya
may
jema.
Every person,
kila mtu,
listening to this message,
anasikiza ujumbe huu,
receive divine health.
Apokee afya kiungu.
In Jesus name.
Katika jina la Yesu.
May your relative receive divine health.
Wacha jamii yako apokee afya kiungu.
In Jesus name.
Katika jina la Yesu.
John is saying.
Yohana anasema
that God's will is for every believer to enjoy good health and live well.
Kwa mapenzi ya Mungu ni kila Mkristo afurahie afya njema na aishi vema.
Exodus 23 verse 25.
Kutoka 25 mstari 25.
The Bible says.
Vinasema.
And you shall serve the Lord your God.
Mtatumikia Mungu Mungu wenu.
And he shall bless thy bread and thy water.
Na tabariki maji yetu na mkate wenu.
And I will take sicknesses away from the midst of you.
Nitaondoa magonjwa kati yenu.
As we serve God.
Tunapotumikia Mungu.
With our resources.
Na mali yetu.
As we serve God in the church.
Tunapotumikia Mungu kanisani.
May God bless your water.
Mungu abariki maji yako.
May God bless your bread.
Mungu abariki mkate wako.
Above all, may he remove every sickness in your life and in your family. In Jesus' name, if you get a negative report from the doctor, in the name of Jesus, declare and declare it is well with you. Declare it is well with you. Your body is healed. Your spouse is healed. Your child is healed. Your relative is healed. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When Satan whispers that you have an incurable disease, tell him by the stripes of Jesus, I am healed in the name of Jesus. Take spiritual key. Church.
Kanisa.
Take spiritual key.
Chukua funguo ya kiroho.
And shut every door.
Na ufunge kila mlango.
Of sicknesses.
Ya magonjwa.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
And open the doors of health.
Na ufungue mlango ya afya.
Open by the grace of God the doors of hell.
Fungua kwa neema ya Mungu ufungue mlango ya
afya. By the power of Jesus.
Sema kwa nguvu ya Yesu.
I am well and healed.
Niko vema nimepona.
In Jesus name.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
Diabetes is not your portion.
Sukari sio sehemu yako.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
The other spirit is called what?
Roho nyingine to nini?
But pressure is not your portion. Sickness of any kind is not your portion. You are healed by the blood of Jesus
Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Just take the key like the bleeding woman.
For
12 years she was sick. But she said enough is enough. She said I have gotten a key. When I touch Jesus, I'll be made whole. And she was made whole. And today we have a testimony of what the Lord can do. Psalms 103
Zaburi 103
and verse 5. This is a psalm of David. And David verse 2 he says, praise the Lord, O my soul. Do not forget all his kind deeds. I am using N-E-T. He is the one who forgives all your sins and heal all your diseases. And does what?
Anafanya nini?
Not one.
Sio moja.
And heal all your diseases.
Anaponya magonjo yako yote.
Who deliver your life from the pit.
Anakomboa uhai wako kutoka kaburini.
Some of you are in a pit of financial difficulties.
Wengine mko katika shimo ya kukua
pesa. That can be another sickness.
Inza kuwa magonjo ingine.
Come out in the name of Jesus.
Toka katika jina la Yesu.
He said, who crowns you with the oil of love and compassion. He satisfies your life with good things. Your youth will be renewed like an eagle. Receive healing and wellness in your life. Let us appreciate God. Amen.
Amen.
As I finish, this is very powerful. And that I wanted to leave it, but the Spirit of the Lord is telling me I continue because there is a purpose for this. Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
The key
funguo
of divine opportunities.
Ya nafasi za kiungu.
Amen. The key of divine opportunities.
Funguo ya nafasi za kiungu.
Some of us are not progressing
wengine wetu hatuendelei
because opportunities are not coming,
sababu nafasi hazikuji,
or probably when they come
ama zikija labda
you miss out,
unakosa.
In the name of Jesus,
katika jina la Yesu,
I prophesy in this church,
natabiri kwa kanisa,
none of us,
hakuna wetu,
will miss out,
atakosa
his opportunity,
nafasi yake,
in the name of Jesus,
katika jina la Yesu.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, opportunity,
unajua nafasi,
the meaning of opportunity,
maana ya nafasi,
is a chance,
ni nafasi,
for advancement and success,
ya kuendelea na kufanikiwa.
Amen.
Amen.
Do you want to succeed?
Unataka kufanikiwa?
Do you want to advance?
Unataka kwenda mbele?
Our opportunity is a chance for advancement and success.
Ni nafasi ya kufanikiwa na kwenda mbele.
To some of you,
kwa wengine wenyu,
doors of opportunities have been shut.
Milango ya nafasi imefungwa.
And you have been mark timing for a long time.
Na umekwama kwa muda.
Look at the 1 Thessalonians chapter 2.
Angalia Wathesalonike wa kwanza 2.
In verse 17.
17.
Use NLT.
Tafsiri NLT.
The Bible says.
Binasema
1 Thessalonians 2:17.
Wathesalonike wa kwanza.
This is Paul. And he is saying,
anasema,
dear brothers and sisters,
ndugu na dada,
after we were separated from you for a little while,
kwa muda mchache,
though our hearts never left you,
hata kama mioyo yenu haikuacha,
we tried hard to come back,
tulijaribu kwa muda kurudi,
because of our intense longing to see you.
Sababu ya tamaa yetu ya kuwaona.
Verse 18.
18.
We wanted very much to come to you.
Tulitaka sana kuja kwenu.
And I, Paul,
na mimi Paulo,
tried again and again.
Nikajaribu mara na mara ingine.
But Satan prevented us.
Lakini shetani akatuzuia.
Paul had an opportunity.
Paulo alikuwa na nafasi.
To move out from where he was.
Kutoka mahali alikuwa.
To go to where God wanted him to be.
Kwenda mahali Mungu alitaka akue.
But the Bible says.
Biblia inasema.
Satan prevented them.
Shetani aliwazuia.
My prayer in the name of Jesus.
Ombi langu katika jina la Yesu.
Whatever the door that has been locked by the devil.
Milango yote ambayo imefungwa na shetani.
Or by people.
Ama na watu.
Or by your boss.
Ama na bwana mkuu wako.
Or by your community.
Ama na jamii yako.
May it be open now.
Ifunguke sasa.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
No witch doctor.
Binti.
In your life.
Maishani mwako.
Will prevail.
Ambayo itaenea.
No man.
Hakuna mtu.
Will prevail.
Ataenea.
No Satan.
Hakuna shetani.
Satan will not prevail.
Shetani atafanikiwa.
Because we have the key.
Sababu una ufunguo.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
He had an opportunity.
Alikuwa na nafasi.
But Satan blocked him.
Shetani akamzuia.
Use the key of opportunity.
Tumia funguo ya nafasi.
Look at this. You still using NLT.
Natumia tafsiri ya NLT bado tafsiri.
2 Corinthians 2:12.
Wakorintho wa pili 2:12.
The Bible says.
Binasema.
When I came to the city of Troas.
Nilipokuja katika eneo la Troas.
To preach the gospel of good news.
Kuhubiri njili habari njema.
This is very good.
Hii ni nzuri sana.
The Lord opened a door of opportunity for me.
Mungu alifungua mlango wa nafasi kwangu.
Who opened the door?
Nani alifungua nafasi?
May you receive those doors of opportunities.
Pokea milango na nafasi katika jina la Yesu.
And these doors came from God.
Na milango ilitoka kwa Mungu.
Some of you have missed opportunities.
Wengine mmekosa nafasi.
May those opportunities look for you.
Watch the nafasi zikutafute.
May those opportunities chase you.
Hiyo nafasi zikukimbize.
May this opportunity chase this church.
Hiyo nafasi ikimbize kanisa.
You know there are times.
Unajua kuna nyakati.
You don't have now to go to look for them.
Hauhitaji kwenda kuzitafuta.
May jobs come start lose. Wanauliza mko wapi? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Wateja biashara unauliza mimi hata kama kuna line itasimama kwa biashara yako.
Amen.
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 Our God is well able.
Mungu wetu ni mweza yote.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
So Paul is telling us to focus on God.
Paulo atuambia tutazamie Mungu.
Who is able to open the door of opportunity.
Ambao kuna uwezo wa kufungua mlango wa nafasi.
May God open that door.
Mungu afungue mlango.
May he make divine opportunity look for you.
Afanye nafasi za kiungu zikutafute.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
May you excel.
Wacha ufanikiwe.
And every door be opened in the name of Jesus.
Kila mlango ufunge katika jina la Yesu.
From today grab your key.
Kuanzia leo chukua funguo yako.
And say my door is open.
Sema mlango umefunguliwa.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
For our God.
Maana Mungu wetu.
He is the one who opens. He says in Revelation 3:7 as we close, to the church of Philadelphia I write, these are the words to him who is holy, true and hold the key of David, that is Jesus Christ. What he opens, no one can shut. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And what he shuts,
funga,
no one can open.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise
the name of the living God.
Amen.
And he says,
na nasema,
I have placed before you
nimeweka mbele yako
an open door,
mlango ambao umefunguka,
that no one can shut.
Ambaye hakuna anaweza funga.
That no one can shut.
Hakuna anaweza funga.
These are the last words.
In maneno ya mwisho,
I have opened for you.
Nimefungua kwako
a door,
mlango
that nobody can shut.
Ambao hakuna mtu anaweza funga.
And what he has shut,
na kile amefunga,
that has affected your life.
Ambaye imeathiri maisha
yako. That has affected your children.
Ambaye imeathiri watoto wako.
That has affected your marriage.
Ambaye imeathiri ndoa yako.
That has affected your business. That has affected your life. In the name of Jesus, Jehovah says, when he closes that door, it has affected your health. When he closes that door, that door is closed and closed for good. For our God is well able. In the name of Jesus, oh God, some of you don't sleep at night because there are challenges. You are wondering what next. Your children have challenged you. In the name of Jesus, my God and my Father has closed all those doors that has brought troubles in your life. And when I speak it, don't wait for another prayer. I am prophesying over your lives. In the name of Jesus, I am here to tell you, some of you will get a report this week that opportunities for better jobs have come. Go quickly. Grab it. That is an opportunity. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. May every shut door in your life be open. In the name of Jesus. May your missed opportunities be open in Jesus' name. May every stubborn door or gate be open. Final scripture. I'll go before you. Isaiah 45 verse 2. I will go before you and I will level the mountains. Hallelujah. There has been mountains before you. You have been trying to move, but it's too hard. That mountain, the Lord is saying, I have removed it in the name of Jesus. He says, Hallelujah, verse 2. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'll break down the gates of bronze and cut through the bars of iron.
He is
saying,
anasema,
the doors,
milango,
that has been closed, it is not only the key that will be used, but it will be broken. It will be a highway for you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It shall be a highway for you. Let us stand up in Jesus' name.
Tusimame katika jina la Yesu.
Just stand up in Jesus' name.
Tusimame wote katika jina lake Yesu Kristo.
Just go before God.
Na mbele za Mungu.
And just tell the Lord.
Waambie Mungu.
Use the key of self-examination.
Funguo ya kujichunguza mwenyewe.
Examine your spiritual life.
Chunguza maisha yako kwa Kristo.
How is your relationship with God? If there is a sin that you need to repent, repent today in the name of Jesus. There is the key of prayer. A prayer opens the doors of impossibility. Just use that door in the name of Jesus. The key of divine health. Decree healing as your portion. And key of divine opportunities. May you be ushered to greatness from today in the name of Jesus. Just go before God in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Ori bashatara mama sakayandara baba. Rikayandere rababo sekebe shandere Riakandere Rababo Zikayaraba Kuriba Sikayandere Rababa Shantarababoria. Father, we want to thank you because you have given us Jehovah, the keys, the loving King of all glory, my God and my Father, the key of self-examination. If there is anything, the loving King of all glory, in our lives, oh my God, that is not right, oh my God. May you cleanse us, oh my God, with the blood that you shed on Calvary. In the name of Jesus, may we, as we use the key of prayer, we decree, oh God, whatever impossible cases there, my Father, you have answered Jehovah. Whatever the mountain that have been there, you have leveled it in the name of Jesus. And I want to thank you, dear loving King of all glory, because of the key of divine health, oh God, divine healing, Jehovah God, which has opened in the lives of your people. We decree it as well, oh God, the key of opportunities, oh God. Father, we want to thank you that through your grace, you have opened it to the glory of your holy name. Receive the glory, receive the honor. Just go before God. Just go before God. Just speak something. Speak something to the Lord. Tell God something about your life, about this church, about your family, about the government, about every area. Oriba shatara mama shendere rababo zekayandara. Rikan eba shekebe kayarababo sheke darababoria. Let's raise up our hands.
Do you know mikono yetu?
Heavenly Father, we want to thank you.
Baba wa mbinguni, nataka shukuru.
Even for this message.
Hata kwa huu jumbe.
About the power of spiritual keys, O God.
Kuhusu mlango wa kufungwa za kiroho, Baba.
You have told us today.
Umetuambia leo.
That we do what we call self-examination.
Tufanye kile tunaita kujichunguza wenyewe.
That will give us self-awareness.
Ambayo inatufanya tujijue wenyewe.
Our strength and our weaknesses, O God.
Nguvu zetu na udhaifu wetu.
If there is one who is here, Jehovah.
Kama yote yako hapa, Yehova.
And Father, due to our circumstances, he may not be able to use other keys. May you forgive, O God, as they do the self-examination. May they draw now unto you, O God.
And
I want to thank you for the key, O God, of prayer, O Jehovah, to do the impossible. May it be released in their lives, Jehovah. I speak the key of health and divine healing in their lives. For anybody who is sick, in the name of Jesus, I shut all powers of sicknesses in the name of Jesus and decree it as well with them in the name of Jesus, as they flourish spiritually, physically,
Jehovah,
may they continue to flourish in the name of Jesus. I want to thank you,
Jehovah,
for the key of divine opportunities they have waited for long. May it be released now. And I want to thank you,
Jehovah,
for what you are about to do now is to the glory of your holy name. And I want to thank you, oh God, this is the end of the last day of the month of the first half of
2024.
As we enter the last 6 months Jehovah God of 2024, I want to thank you, Jehovah, for your grace and mercy. Divine grace, Jehovah. Oh God, for the next 6 months, you are people, this church, we're going to experience great grace, miracles and wonders to the glory of your holy name. Jesus, we give you praise. May you take all the glory. It's all about you. Jesus Christ, touch your people because you have given us power and authority. And I decree it is done in their lives. Every struggle, every pain, oh God, many of them have been so patient. Oh God, speaking, oh God, waiting on you. Their time and opportunity has come. For the online people, answer every prayer. In Jesus' name, we pray and we believe. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Let's appreciate the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. God bless you, online viewers. Prepare to give online viewers. We have a number there.
449-63.
You can give your offerings and the tithes, or as the Spirit of the Lord will lead you. In the name of Jesus, see you next Sunday. God bless you mightily. We love you and value you. In the name of Jesus, from today, take the keys of the spiritual keys. Which has power to open every door. Praise the name of the living God.
Amen.
We love you all. God bless you mightily. Amen and amen.
Amen.